let's work on this one. Another fraction. So we have to simplify the numerator separately from the denominator and then see if we can simplify further. So negative 10 plus negative 2, you're adding two negative signs, two negative numbers, so it's still going to be negative, and 10 plus 2 is 12. So the numerator is easy to simplify. Now the denominator, remember I have to do exponents first before subtraction. So 6 squared is 6 times 6, and that's 36 minus 30. No canceling, remember? We have to simplify the bottom until we just get a single number. So now I've got 36 minus 30, and the denominator will be 6. Lastly, I've got negative 12 divided by 6, so it's going to be negative, and 12 divided by 6 is 2. So the answer to this one ended up being a negative number, no fraction. Okay, here's another one. Well, I've got fractions, I've got negative numbers with exponents, etc. So let's start off with a fraction simplifying the numerator and denominator. Remember, we have to sort of think like they're both in parentheses, no canceling to start off. So as I do this problem, I'm going to copy everything up into that point. And let's do it. So in the numerator, I've got 3 cubed minus 7. I'm going to have to do the exponents first. Remember, 3 cubed is 3 times 3 times 3. That is 27 minus 7. And in the denominator, I have 2 cubed plus 2. Remember, 2 cubed is 2 times 2 times 2, so that's 8 plus 2. And then I have over here minus the negative 2 squared. Resist any temptation you have to change these two minus signs to plus signs. Still not done simplifying that fraction. So we have 4 times, okay, 27 minus 7 is 20. And 8 plus 2 is 10. All right, getting closer. I still have minus the negative 2 squared. So now I can do this. 20 divided by 10 is just 2. So this finally gets down to 16 minus 4 times 2. Whew. All right, I've gotten rid of the fraction, which was really like grouping symbols in a way. And now I'm looking to see if there are any exponents. And here we go. I've got the negative 2 to the second power. But if you want, remember, you can do all three of these at the same time with your little underlining trick. So 16 minus, well, 4 times 2 is 8. And the reason we could do that is, remember, the last thing we do is subtraction. And negative 2 to the second power, that means, by the way, on the side, negative 2 times negative 2. So what's that going to give you? Positive 4. And now I have to subtract from left to right. So 16 minus 8 is 8. And then I have minus 4. And then finally, 8 minus 4 is 4. So this all simplifies to 4. Let's just start up with a little warm-up here. All right, so we're going to try to simplify this using the order of operations, which means we'll use the order of operations to get it to just a single number. Okay, now remember, you can't just start off going left to right and write 6 plus 3. No, the first thing you need to do is look for any grouping symbols, which we have two of them here. We have some brackets and we have some parentheses, and you start with the innermost ones. So the innermost ones right here, it's 1 plus 1. We're going to have to simplify that. So we need to copy everything up into that place. And there's a 3 in front of that parentheses, so you could either just write the parentheses and put 2, or remember, 3 in extra parentheses means times whatever that parentheses simplifies to be, which is 2. 1 plus 1 is 2. Okay, so we've simplified what was in the parentheses. Now, we still have some grouping symbols. We have these brackets. So now we have to simplify within the brackets. Again, do not do the distributive property. Do not add 6 plus 3. So we have 6 plus 3. Now, inside the grouping symbols, what do I do? Well, in here, I've got a subtraction and a multiplication, and remember, multiplication is done before subtraction. So we're going to do 3 times 2 first, not 8 minus 3. So we have 8 minus 6. All right? So we still have to simplify within those brackets. So we have 6 plus 3. Now, we could easily use the brackets, which again, 3 next to a grouping symbol means multiply, or we could simply write down the time sign here, and 8 minus 6 is 2. All right. Finally, no grouping symbols. So the next thing to do would be this multiplication, the 3 times 2. Again, happens to be 3 times 2. That is just a coincidence. So we have 6 plus 6, and the answer is now 12. Okay, so that's a little warm-up. Still no fractions, no decimals, no negative numbers, but we had to deal with a few grouping symbols. Here's a similar problem. So let's do the same thing. We're going to work within the innermost grouping symbols. We copy everything up to there. Now, we're just subtracting what's in the parentheses. What's in the parentheses is just 1. So you simply have to write 1. This time there wasn't any multiplication. There was no number in front of the parentheses, so we simply write 8 minus 1. So we have to now simplify within the brackets. So we have 3 minus 2 times, well, 8 minus 1 is 7. So remember, this means 2's in front of the brackets. That means 2 times 7. Keep in mind, you could write it as 3 minus 2 times 7 like that, or 3 minus 2 times 7 like that, with parentheses or with brackets. They all mean the same thing. Okay, next step is we have to do the 2 times 7 since multiplication comes before the subtraction. So we've got 3 minus 14. All right, so here's something a little different. 3 minus 14, we're going to have to change that to add the opposite. So that's 3 plus a negative 14. And the rule for when you're adding a positive and negative number is negative 14 outweighs the positive 3. So the answer is going to be negative. So when you have opposite signs, you take their difference. 14 minus 3 is 11. So the answer is negative 11. Here's one where you have to deal with fractions and negative numbers. All right. So basically, you've got multiplication here and some exponents. So remember, we could take the exponents and rewrite it as multiplication. So 3/4 to the second power, or 3/4 squared, means 3/4 times 3/4. Now I'm also multiplying by negative 4. Since I have a fraction, I'm going to write everything with fractions. So I'm going to think of that as a negative 4 over 1. And then we have a 2 cubed. I could write that as 8, or I could write that as 2 times 2 times 2. That's pretty simple to do. 2 cubed is 8, so I'm going to write this as 8 over 1. All right, now we're going to see if anything can cancel. But before doing that, let's decide, since this is all multiplication, if the answer is going to be positive or negative. Well, there's one negative sign, so the answer is going to be negative, and that way we can just deal with the numerical part. So let's see. This 4 will go into that 4. Notice the negative sign is still there. And this 4 will go into 8 2 times. So I didn't write this out, but this means there's left with ones here, and there's a 1 left here. So on the bottom, I've got all 1s. So I'm going to have some number divided by 1. So the answer is going to be a whole number at the top, except the minus sign out in front. So what do I have here? I'm left with 3 times 3 times 1 times 2. So that's 18. So the answer is going to be negative 18. I hope you learned something. Remember, math is cool.